There's a famous line that Walter Mondale used against Ronald Reagan in their presidential debate, and it goes something like this. It's not what he doesn't know that bothers me. It's what he knows for sure that just ain't so. And boy, can I relate to that. Not about politics, but about brain health. There is so little information available online for people with mild cognitive impairment. But here's what bothers me the most. When I look at the scant information out there, too often it is frightening or misleading or just plain wrong. Hi, I'm Tony Deering of GoCogno.com, the website for people with mild cognitive impairment. I'm in a foul mood today. And here's what set me off. It's an article just published by Consumer Reports on supplements and brain health. Now, Consumer Reports is one of the most trusted, authoritative sources of information out there. But when it comes to what people with MCI need to know about supplements and brain health, this article is a clunker. It tells us, according to a review of studies published this past December, there's virtually no good evidence that such products, meaning supplements, vitamins, can prevent or delay memory lapses, mild cognitive impairment, or dementia in older adults. It goes on to specifically single out fish oils, B vitamins, and ginkgo, and it says, decades of research have yet to demonstrate their benefits. My first problem with this article is that it makes a blanket statement that's true for most people, but not true for everyone, and definitely not true for mild cognitive impairment. In brain health, you can put people in three buckets. There's cognitively normal adults, there's people diagnosed with MCI, and there's people diagnosed with Alzheimer's or other forms of dementia. For people who fall in the first group or the third group, the article is basically correct. There's no evidence that supplements like this can benefit people who are cognitively normal or who have dementia. But for people with mild cognitive impairment, the opposite is true. There is clear evidence that it may benefit people in some cases. If you're deficient in certain vitamins or nutrients, and specifically things like omega-3 fatty acids, DHA, or the B vitamins or vitamin D, that can result in significant cognitive decline. It's very common for older adults to be deficient in these things. And if that deficiency is detected and corrected, your memory can improve. Now, not to harangue Consumer Reports or give them a bad time, it's just that I'm really tired of reading these kind of articles in the general press, because the message always seems to be, nothing works, why bother trying, just go sit in a corner and whimper. There is so many things you can do to defend your cognition, and supplements may be one of them. Now, any doctor will tell you that it's ideal to get vitamins and nutrients through the food you eat, and I agree completely with that. But it's important to understand that many older adults have reasons that they can't get some of these vitamins through natural sources, and if they become deficient and it affects their cognition, they need supplements. Here's what it boils down to. When you buy a car, do you consult your doctor? No, you go to Consumer Reports because that's where you can get the best, most accurate information that you're looking for. But we're not talking about a Buick here. We're talking about your brain. And personally, I do not trust my brain health to whatever I happen to stumble across after an internet search. Because I read these things, and when I look at them, I find that they're often outdated or irrelevant. And some of what's out there is just plain crap. So talk to your doctor. Get good medical advice that's relevant to you and your situation. Or if you're looking for accurate information, you have a question, send an email to me at tonydeering@gocogno.com, and I will be glad to point you to a source of information that I know is current and accurate. I hope that's somewhat helpful to you. I apologize for my rant today. I do look forward to seeing you again next week. Until then, as always, be kind to your mind.